Welcome to the Top 5 on Press TV. American officials have warned Europe over its outreach to Iran, saying the approach is poisoning the relations between the European Union and Washington. Top State Department official Brian Hook says Brussels and Washington should be working together to counter Iran. Hook says Europe's recent aid package to Iran sends the wrong message at the wrong time. He says the package stands in the way of meaningful policy changes in Iran. Also, a congressional official speaking on condition of anonymity says the Europe has deliberately chosen Iran over the U.S. for financial gains. Meanwhile, France and Germany have announced that they are working on a solution to sidestep the anti-Iran U.S. sanctions.
With Germany, we are determined to work on an independent European or Franco-German financing tool which would allow us to avoid being the collateral victims of U.S. extraterritorial sanctions.
Bruno Le Maire said that he wants Europe to be a sovereign continent and have its own independent financing instruments. Also, the German foreign minister said that Europe needs to strengthen its autonomy and trade and economic policy. Heiko Maas added that the EU is working to protect economic ties with Iran and keep payment channels open. In May, U.S. President Donald Trump pulled his country out of the Iran nuclear deal and reimposed sanctions on Tehran. Europe has been trying to salvage the deal ever since. To shed more light on that situation, we're joined by Alexander Azadegan, senior geopolitical analyst and editor-at-large with the imperialnews.com. Thank you very much, Mr. Azadegan, once again for joining us. Now, what do you make of this take on how the Europe is choosing Iran over? Is Europe actually choosing Iran over the United States, or is Europe simply trying to go in the direction where it's in the interests of its own nations rather than feeding U.S. interests?
Thank you for your invitation. It's always joyful to be with Press TV. First of all, Europe changing direction, I think, is a long-term strategy that the Europeans are discussing amongst themselves in the context of sovereign nations or even the survival of the EU in the decades to come. So there is meat to that kind of argument. There is validity to that. Having said that, as far as this congressional official who you just mentioned spoke on the conditions of anonymity, I don't take those things too seriously until identities are revealed. I don't think Europe is going to choose Iran over its $1.1 trillion transaction. These are numbers from the Office of the United States Trade Representative, figures going back to 2016 as far as the exchange of trade between U.S. goods and services. It's almost totaling nearly $1.1 trillion with EU exporting $592 billion to U.S. So I don't buy the argument that they're going to choose Iran over United States. I think this is psychological warfare. I think this is a sort of like a Jekyll and Hyde, you know, good cop, bad cop, bait and switch game. And the proof is in the pudding. How France reneged, the French companies Total and PSA reneged their tens of billions of dollars of contract with the Iranians. This $21 million financial package that the Europeans are extending to the Iranians, frankly, as an American of Iranian heritage, I'm insulted by that. There was some talk about EIB, European Investment Bank, wanting to provide some protection for small to mid-sized European businesses investing in Iran. Of course, those of us who know what that is all about, it's a joke. Small to medium-sized businesses would not invest in Iran because of the risks that they perceive. So going back to your question, the autonomy is a serious project. The Europeans are sick and tired of 72 years, more or less, since the end of World War II, of being relatively economic vassal states, if you may, from a big perspective. We have to remember Europeans were all colonial powers and powers unto themselves until Washington came into the scene and took over. So in that sense, there are many that are frustrated with that. And some within the European factions feel that Iran is a conduit, is a reason, is an excuse, is an opportunity for Europe to change direction and be more autonomous. You mentioned France and Germany. I would rely more on Germany. As an analyst, we forecast more German behavior modification, if you may. They are indicating wanting to be closer to Russia, which Iran could benefit from if Iran is not sacrificed, as a matter of fact, between Russia and Germany. But the French, I would not count them on them at all, because it's just been, you know, more talk and not enough action. What I really want to see, as far as solutions to sidestepping anti-Iran U.S. sanctions, I would like to see more solid legislation at the European Parliament and legislation level, just enacting laws protecting European countries from U.S. sanctions, and really standing up to Washington. Some say that Europe has started that process, that there's going to be this new international order of geopolitics and geoeconomics, if you may, new world order, an interesting phrase here. So that process has begun, but I think in the short term, Europeans are being very, very cautious. And Washington is very clear. John Bolton, not too many days ago, more or less, repeated that old neocon George W. Bush sentence that either you're with us or against us. He didn't use this exact sentence, but he said that Europe should be either close to us or Iran, which if you ask me, the entire world is sick and tired of this mafia, gangster, bullying, so-called diplomacy, which it's not diplomacy, it's just arm twisting. And in that sense, the Iranians may still want to sort of see if they can revive or keep alive the JCPOA with their Russian, Chinese, and those three countries in Europe.
Thank you very much, Mr. Alexander Azadegan. As always, your comments are always appreciated on Press TV.